was a bad idea. This was a bad idea. I forgot about my hip.
But all good.
Good evening at a new live stream at the Tuesday evening with me, Michael from Rapalje, and I guess we have a guest, but if you saw the thumbnail, you already know who the guest is because you saw him on the picture. But this is Diep's violin. Diep's violin. And yeah, we are using it for new Rapalje show, and somebody's going to play on it. And we're going to start with a song. This place we come to, we don't know what to say. We learn to see each other, frightened of the day. You met me in a barren place, you walked me to the hill. Could have been so good for each other then, I know we could be still. Did you ever do a live stream on Tuesday evening with us?
Never.
Never ever.
First time.
Welcome, Sebas.
Dankjewel.
Sebas. What's your stage name?
Sebas. No, just kidding. Sebastian, Sebastian, Sebas, Seb, Sebas.
Okay, we favorites. Want to know. We want to know in our comments which one of these names you like best. Just write down the name, how you want to pronounce, or write down his name. His official name is Sebastian. You can write it with one A when it's English. Sebastian.
Yeah.
Sebas.
Yeah.
Seb.
Seb.
Yeah. Tian.
Be creative.
Yeah. Ian.
Tian.
Ian.
That's new. That's new.
Astian.
Astian.
Think about how would you like to pronounce him in the future. And write in the comment section. We're going to read all your comments because we're going to talk about Sebastian playing along with Rapalje. And we need to do a lot of stuff before we can no longer call you guest musician. It took David 6 years.
That's 7, I heard.
7 years. 7 years. Yeah, 7 years he had the guest musician status. It could be 7 years work to get you also playing every song.
It's a good goal. Hopefully better faster than that, sorry.
Yeah, so we are working on what kind of tunes where and how to play things. We are working on little practices today. But we are right now working on a good sound on stage.
Yeah, exactly.
And in a recording.
How to amplify the fiddle, where to amplify the fiddle.
Yeah, maybe you can show what we did. This is a deep violin. And you can go very close to the
very close.
Yeah, and show what it is. It's a very tiny thing that I built. I rebuilt
a little pickup.
Yeah, little pickup. This is the amplification system. This is what picks up the sound. And we need to find the right spot. You see a deep spot is over here.
You can still see deep spot. focuses, there it is.
Yeah.
And just playing around with the position of the microphone to see which gives the most natural sound.
So if you have any questions about that, please tell us in the comments. Sebastian Seps, Sepsian is going to read the Facebook comments. So if you see a nice...
So there are a lot of comments there.
So if you see a question or a comment, so that's nice, please reply. Just break in.
Yeah.
I will go to YouTube and see what you're writing and see what you like. And like everyone knows, I'm a real sound nerd. And Sebastian knows it now.
Oh, definitely.
He doesn't understand a lot of things that we're doing, actually. He's like, it's like magic.
It is.
Well, that's the phrase of my company, Sounds Like Magic.
Well chosen.
Yeah. Bossy.
Bossy?
John Richard writes, Bossy.
Can I vote for one name? Not to be called.
Bossy and Adriaan.
There you go. Sebastian Adriaan.
Basti. That's a German version, eh? Basti.
Basti. I did get a nice question already.
Okay.
On the Facebook feed. It says there, what is your favorite note to play in the violin and favorite song to play?
Note. Only one note.
The favorite one.
What's your favorite note?
That's a very hard question. They're all beautiful. Favorite note. I'm not sure if I have a favorite note.
Play it, please play it.
Find
the favorite note.
I do like...
It could be the brown note.
There you go. I do like the low in the violin like this. There you go. With the... but just like an A, low A. Because it always brings it back to that bass note somehow. Really gives a fundament.
I know a good instrument for you. Cello.
Oh, definitely.
Can you play cello?
I'd love that. I can play violin like this.
I also have a favorite note. It's easy. You know...
Catch your note.
Yeah. That's the low D. This one. This. Because it's
a low note.
It's the lowest note. This is the special thing about this instrument. It has a low D. Drop D bass note. You can. This is my favorite string, actually. It's not the G string. It's my the G string is his favorite string. That's the G string.
Either a G or a D or together, like.
But all favorite. We all always have the G. This is a D. G. Yeah. Same note. If you can hear it. Yeah. Going to learn everything about music right now. This live stream. But these G strings tend to break a lot. So when you hear a musician in a hair wearing a kilt, oh dear, I broke a G string, They meant the string on the instrument.
Exactly that. Might be confusing for once.
Because we're not wearing strings on stage.
Sure.
Only instruments
we're wearing. Scottish underwear is that we wear.
Scottish underwear, yeah.
I'm just seeing if there's anything there. Favourite song to play as well is the same in the same question there.
The same question. Yeah, what's your favourite song to play?
Favourite song to play?
Right now, with Rapalje.
With Rapalje?
Oh, I know that.
Then I'll leave it to you.
I know that.
Oh, here we go.
Okay. We play a small part and then you play the tune.
That, you're right.
I can play one and then you go. I sing one phrase and then you play one round, okay?
Yeah.
Now my love, my name is leave you. My intent is not to grieve you. But indeed, when I deceive you, I will see you in a while.
Yeah, you're right. It was right. That's actually my favorite tune to play. The tune's amazing.
Yeah, it's and called Stride.
The Stride.
Yeah.
I saw that Falkland Slantje is watching as well. They love that song.
Yeah, it's a great. So I have so John Lekker drinking beer. Is he a Zoom meeting? People are talking about the Zoom meeting a lot on YouTube. So we are going to have a Zoom meeting, half an hour.
Yeah.
Zoom meeting for everyone, and then maybe special questions, a bit extra. So when somebody got something really interesting, a question where we can help out, musical things, things about the sound system, whatever, Zoom meeting is there.
I have a nice question here. Okay. Welke pickup gebruik je in je bouzouki? What kind of pickup do you use for the bouzouki?
Yeah, okay, show you. Yeah, sure, close again. Wait a minute, turn the mic. You can see there it is, and it's called a Fishman Rare Earth Blender System. I ruined the light. It's a Fishman. Find Fishman Rare Earth Blender. There's a microphone in my case, and it's a magnetic pickup system, and it's one of the best systems I ever heard. I hope to use it later. So I come to.
I'm still looking at the nicknames.
Did you find a nice one?
Yeah, there's great nicknames there as well.
Yeah?
Oh, it starts with, well, obviously, Basti Sebi. I can live with that.
Basti Sebi.
But then there's this beautiful one. It says, Sebi Fideli.
Oh, no, say it again.
Sebi Fideli, like an Italian or something.
Fideli, on the fiddle.
Sounds like a nice dish. Sounds like a nice dish.
Yeah. Oh, like a pasta.
I love the pizza Sebi Fideli.
That's good. Great, the sound of a violin. Johanna Maria writes. Yeah, what we're going to do probably next week or whenever you have a Tuesday off again, which is every Tuesday, I guess, we are going to make recordings from the violin with his pickup system because we want a great sound on stage. For recordings, you mostly need a good microphone. We're also going to do that. We're going to make two recordings, a good microphone, the pickup system, and then we're going to play them over the little Pixie speakers over here in the live stream. So you can hear if there's a difference between the recording or a real violin. Yeah. Because I, as a real sound nerd, I want to have the violin sound and the voices and the gitukki in every other instrument for every band. I wanted the recording to sound like real instruments in your room. You need a special sound system for that, a very good one, but you also need good recordings and you have to pick it up.
Like to sound like we're actually there,
yeah,
playing for you,
yeah,
in private.
And that's what we do on stage, of course, but then also the sound has to be very, very good, starting at the recording and the performance, of course.
Yep.
I will check our Patreon page. Yeah. I will work on new videos soon. I actually recorded some videos already, but did not put them online yet. First, they will be on Patreon. Every Patreon sponsor, many videos are coming up, special ones, that are special recordings from the live stream. The songs that you hear in the live stream recorded, are newly edited, and sound a little bit better, and especially edited for patrons. And then I, 1 week later, put them online. I also wanted to say that the Pixie sound system is now available on our shop, not as a pre-sale. I'm going to change that tomorrow. This week, Thursday, in 2 days, I will send every system that you ordered. And also, when you're ordering the sound system right now, I will send it in 2 days. So it's not a pre-sale or pre-order anymore. It's now really online. I only got 12 right now for you, so, but it's enough for now. So please, go to our shop, the link's in the description, and see if you also want to have the real violent sound from whatever band with good recording in your house, then that's possible.
And be there before it sells out?
Yeah, they sell out quickly, yeah. Last weekend we saw two at the concert.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, but there's a small upgrade to the system, and it's I will have it tomorrow. I will show it tomorrow. I wanted to see my view page, wait a minute, my comments on our Patreon page, because I'm talking about Patreon. Okay, we got four comments here. The first one, Feli, if Sebastian becomes the fourth member, I would be glad. To miss his talent would be really sad. He shows he has more than just finance skills. His deep low voice helps fill the thrills. The tills. Deep is not to replace. We all know the fact, but there's no reason Sebastian to reject.
I don't feel rejected, just to clear that.
Let's reject. Erase.
Erase. Never.
Okay, before I read out the next poem, I got a comment from Heiko Wiemeyer. Doesn't Deep play violin at all now, even at home? I don't know. Do you know? He cannot play the violin. Well, because
not on this one, obviously.
The violin is here.
I am pretty sure that it has multiple violins.
Yeah,
like any fiddle player thing.
I really hope so. We hope for Deep all the best, that he's having a normal life, that he can get out, has a pleasure time at home. Next week, or in 2 weeks, I'm going to bring a sound system to Deep's place. He already got a new computer from us to work on a computer, to do things, to watch television, whatever he does on the computer. He's also, maybe designing stuff. But he also going to get a new sound system, a Pixie sound system, this one. I will have it as a small gift from us. And we can ask him if he plays the violin, and I hope he's doing well in his at his place, at his home, and getting good food and good treatment and good... Yeah.
All the best, Deep.
All the best. All the best to you, yeah. Heiko also asked if... I heard Sebastian is well known in the Dutch music scene. What bands did he play in?
Oh, well,
did you and do you?
That's a good question. I did and I do. I used to have multiple bands. We started off when I was young, playing different bands. I used to play in Flannery, the Celtic folk band, with David's brother.
Yeah, yeah. You're not playing Flannery anymore? On occasions?
No, I haven't played with them in years.
Ah.
Actually, so that was one of my former bands. I still play in the Highland Sellouts.
Yeah.
I used to play in the Dolmen, the British band. For somewhat a bit more than a year, I think that was. Then I used to play in the Freelancers, which is not very active at the moment. Still doing gigs every now and then.
With Jerry.
With Jerry, yeah.
We can invite Jerry next time because he's living right here.
That's a great idea.
I'm not telling next week, but we try to get him next week here. Get a small gig, the three of us.
Yeah, no, that'd be great. Yeah,
yeah, practice definitely. Some things. Jerry lives here 100 meters away.
Very close by. Very close by. He can probably hear us.
Yeah, I can. When he walks by, he can see us. Hello.
There he is.
It's all open here. People wonder what we're doing right here.
I have another question from Bert Hensema, who says, Deep used to sing A Bog Down in the Valley. Sebastian, is there a chance you will sing this with Rapalje?
And?
That's a lot of practice, I reckon. That's a lot of text.
Is it in the book, actually? I don't think it is. Of course, we also have the Rapalje songbook. It's in the shop.
It is, yeah, definitely. That's
it's very funny. I have to solve this tomorrow. But when you go look for the sound system, you also find this book, because the categories in our shop are not correct. But I found our Rapalje songbook at in the Rapallo sound system category. So if you try to find it, you find both. But yeah, this is you could have come a better time. What we just did,
that practiced, and Sebastian plays along with us because of the book.
He always asks me, "Do we have to play some book? I need to. Oh, nice tune! I need to learn this. I need to practice this." And Kalia Paus.
Hey, there he is.
There he is. I just. Yeah,
that's the one after the Search of a Rose.
It's the one inside. Yeah, that's the one.
Exactly.
Yeah,
I was looking for that one.
You can practice.
Thank you for that.
Practice that one. Yeah. Next time, yeah, but because he's singing in Search of a Rose.
Yep.
And then it's nice if you play all the fiddle parts as well, especially the last one, and there's also one in the middle.
There's a lot of space in the song for that, so definitely we'll give that a try.
Oh, we have 10 minutes. I have another poem.
Another poem? Here we go.
From Peter de Jong. Not on all your topics... wait a minute. Again. Not on all your topics, it's easy to write, but I give it a try. Despite an instrument sound amplifying for better use, it's not simply feeding with electrical juice. Electronical components way above my head, you will find a solution, I bet. Sebastian, the violin, which your hands now keep, is the one also played by Deep.
Yeah, there you go. That's beautiful.
I, one of many, am delighted the violin sound is audible once more. It definitely was a missing fragment on the Rapallo core.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, it is Deep's violin that we got right here, right now. So, yeah. It was a definite yes.
Carbon fiber bow can take that.
Yeah, it's not Deep's bow.
Not Deep's bow, that's mine.
Yeah, but this is the violin. And we tried to find the right sound, also acoustically, because when you got a different instrument, you know how to play it, how to hold it, how to because every instrument is different. And then you find your sound acoustically, and then we try to amplify that as best as possible. And then in the future, of course, recordings. Yeah, new recordings, best recording. We want to have the authentic sound of this instrument.
Like we are there.
Like it really sounds. Next week we're going to do some tests to actually on a almost scientific way try to find the right sound, that it's really pure the same, and there's no difference between amplified, recorded, or the real thing. And that's what we're going to work on. It is a lot of work.
I have another question.
Yeah.
Esther van Leeuwen, will you play In Search of a Rose next Saturday? And that's more of a question for David, because he's normally the one who writes the set list, but I'm pretty sure we can convince him to put it on there, can't we?
Okay, you know what we do? We play In Search of a Rose in the Zoom meeting.
That's beautiful.
Yeah?
Nice.
When we're in Zoom, because we only got like 5 minutes for your comments. We race through all the comments, and we see in the Zoom meeting. The link is in the description, and at the Zoom meeting, we will start with trying to play In Search of a Rose. And do you also know the tune?
It's right there.
No, that's the last.
That's the last one.
You need the other one. But we're going to find that one in the Zoom meeting. We find the right tune we're going to do a practice in the Zoom meeting.
We'll figure something out.
Yeah, in the Zoom meeting. So please join in the Zoom meeting. You don't need to open up your microphone. You don't need to open up your camera. You can just join the link. First you go to a Patreon page, but it's a link. You don't need to be a patron. You just go in link, and I will check that now if I've done it right. And if you want to be a patron, afterwards you can go back there again and maybe support these live streams on Patreon to help us with better sound absorption in this room. And I also have some really pretty cool camera ideas. And I also want to put on much more videos online again. It's a lot of work, and if you want to help us out, please become a patron, because that makes us producing more videos and stuff online. This is only for the online content and nothing else. So if you want us online, please support us on Patreon. For the concerts, we don't need patrons, because we get paid by tickets. And by performing, and by and you're actually helping out with the bookings.
Definitely, yeah.
Yeah. What are you doing there?
A lot of phone calls, emails, figuring out which festival to play on, finding nice venues, the full Monty actually. Like really, for now it's mostly researching nice venues to play, finding contact information, seeing how we can contact these people. Best way to promote ourselves, obviously. A whole lot of work.
We're making
nice
new pictures, new videos. It's a fresh restart. So many things need to be done. A lot of cleaning up, a lot of getting new stuff, getting old songs all together, and getting new songs practiced again. And
exactly,
that's what we're doing.
Next to the office work, there's also a whole lot of practice going on.
Yeah. And you said you come to help me out with my mess over here.
Definitely,
my stuff.
Yeah.
And because we, like you see, we're doing a lot of things, and it's hard work. And we do everything ourselves.
Yeah.
We haven't got an agency or a recording studio where we. Talk about recording studios. We're going to do something very special, very nice with recording studios in the near future. I have an idea about that, but I'm not going to spoil it right now. I will talk about it probably next week, what the idea is with us, recording studios, and the Pixie sound system.
Yeah, nice.
Because we have an idea. Again, what we're working on, getting the right sound at your doorstep, at your home, our concerts.
Jeroen ter Horst kijkt. Hi, Jeroen.
Jeroen, please write a comment. Oh, what, Jeroen, how would you like to name this guy over here? I'm not going to tell you how he's called, but maybe have a nice cuddle name. Is that the right
cuddle name?
Koosnaampje.
Oh, koosnaampje. A nickname.
Nickname. Nah, cuddle name. And we have a new English word again on this live stream. Cuddle name.
Another last question, I reckon. Is there still time?
Yeah, we have 2 minutes.
Question is, if I will get a solo song.
Solo song.
A solo song. Krijg je ook een solo nummer?
Oh yeah,
I think that's the comparable with what Deep did with the Bob down in the valley.
Something like that
mentioned before.
Yeah,
that's a good question. Something to think about.
Frank is, I know a musician who can really sing the song Bob down in the valley. Very, very enthusiastic. Frank, who is it? Frank will also be in the Zoom meeting. Please, all join the Zoom meeting. You can already now join the Zoom meeting as we speak because it's already open up. And we're going to play. Rebellia has a question. Sebastian, I really hope you will stay playing with Rapali because you're really an amazing and valuable addition to the sound of the band. I know that she's probably also in a Zoom meeting, so we're going to sing a song for you.
I'll start blushing.
Watching from Cardiff, UK.
Moran's return is a request.
Lucy has a question. Is there a big difference between your violin and Deep's? Well, this is Deep's violin, but you also have other violins.
I didn't bring it today.
But is there a difference in between violins?
Definitely, yeah.
What is it?
The sound of every violin is unique, obviously. And I try to, whenever I try out a violin or am planning on buying another violin, I always try to figure out what's the sound that resonates the most with the music I'm going to play with it. Because I've tried amazing classical violins with sounds that were out of this world and still wasn't happy with the sound it made playing folk music. So that's something you really have to take into account. The difference between Deep's violin and mine is pretty significant, which is also partially due to the strings and the setup. But Deep's fiddle is made for folk music. It's just, I think it is. It's an amazing violin.
It's the one you prefer.
Yeah, definitely. Okay. During gigs, it's the one I prefer. Yeah.
Cool. That's nice. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's very nice to know. So Deep still lives on. many
Deep sound lives on.
Yeah, lives on. I think we are there now with all your questions. David has a question. What other violin players do you look up to? Which violin players do you really like?
That's a good question. Oh. Which violin players do I look up to?
How would you like to play, perform, learn tricks from, or get a lesson from?
Well, the improvisation, improvisational skills of the... I don't even know his name. That's a horrible thing. The violin player for the Trouble Notes. I really like his improv skills. Amazing. I always looked up to André Rieu, obviously, as a little boy playing classical music. That was something I was really interested in all the time. And one of the main reasons I started playing the violin as well. But fiddle players who I look up to. That's a very difficult question. I have to get back to that.
It's a question for later. Maybe in the Zoom meeting, you have a name. In the Zoom meeting, I got...
Of course, Alex and Flo from Versengold.
Oh, yeah. Of course. Versengold. The both of them.
Fucking amazing.
Both of them.
Yeah, definitely.
And we also want to do maybe recordings or gigs with them together. I have ideas about that. What was how to improvise a recorded violin? That's the question. But I have a question in the Zoom meeting. What's your name for Sebastian in the Zoom meeting? That's the question of the day. And maybe you have also... And you can just ask a personal question to Sebastian or whatever, how you call him, Basti.
Seb Fidel.
Whatever you want to call him, you say his name and then you have a question for...
Yeah, Seb Fidel, Seb, Bastian.
Yeah. Not Basti.
And which violins have names?
Violins have names, they do. Yeah.
Yeah. What's the... Is it Elkanone? No, it's not Elkanone.
It's not Elkanone.
Elkanone is another one. What's the name
this
of...
This beautiful lady is called Jolene.
Oh, yeah, it was Jolene, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She plays like a charm.
So, see you in the Zoom meeting. We play a song there and half an hour. And then, new in the Zoom meeting, we have a half an hour. We try to rush through all your names and a quick question. And then we will have more personalized... If you have a question that's really that takes a longer time to explain, we leave that until after this half hour, so it doesn't get boring in the Zoom meeting. Because when you have to explain something for 10 minutes and nobody's interested, you can stay then after half an hour, but you can also leave because then it's only this question and to think about that. Yep. Okay. So we go to the Zoom meeting. Be easy and free.
When you're drinking. With